Vice and President of Ferrari. Without whose support, this conference would not have been possible. Here we are, at this incredible Centro di Mulot, a place that is set in history, thanks to the strong leadership of the Avvocato Agnelli and his successors for Fiat. Obviously, it is a place of memory for me, where a lot of memories I can have with, of course, some emotion. I used to be welcomed here by the board of the Fiat Group to present Ferrari's program to them. This is a symbolic place for Turin as a whole, the capital of Piemonte, a city with an industrial and competitive past, which has very successfully converted itself into a national center for excellence and a metropolis for a strong European dimension. In a nutshell, the Ligo draws a straight line from its past to its present and future, which perfectly mirrors the theme of this year's conference. The Ligo also reminds us of the beginning of the automotive. Graham was talking about it earlier, and you will have the chance to visit later this week. The history of our sport and of its pioneers are contained within the wall of this old factory. Pioneers who put their lives in danger in order to shave off a few kilometers per hour or to test some kind of new invention which was going to make a lasting impression on the automotive industry. I sometimes hear nostalgic echoes, words of regret about the passing of the golden age and how little by little the freedoms have been taken away. I think that all of us united here this afternoon are strong admirers of the heroes of our sport from back in the day, from Louis Chiron to Juan Manuel Fangio, not to mention Giuseppe Farina, and of course, I would like to have a special thought for Enzo Ferrari, the mastermind behind the most iconic sports car brand in the world. However, having respect for their achievement does not mean that we cannot have a critical eye. Instead of longing for the past, would it not make more sense to rejoice in the past that our sport has taken over?